Hello YouTube, this is Optimus Smythe back for another video review, and as you can see today we're looking at Transformers Dark of the Moon Deluxe Class Crankcase, a dread. He's one of the dreads from the movie, and he's pretty cool, but he is inexpensive at least, but he is not the greatest figure, at least not out of the Dark of the Moon line, but not all the deluxes were that great anyhow. But he does have a cool weapon. He should be a lot bigger though. He's too thin, he's not long enough. He should be a Voyager pretty much, but the weapon's pretty cool. It's like this gun up here, and if you pull back on this, it becomes a claw. But like all the deluxes, they don't lock in place, but I've found a way to lock mine in place. I put a little Lego rubber band. I wrapped it around twice, and sometimes it'll be down there, but I kind of shift it upward like that, and that holds this pretty far out enough. It's not completely erect, but it's close enough. So that's how you can lock it in place. Take a little tiny one of those little rubber bands you find in most Lego sets that have them. Wrap it around twice, or if it's tiny enough, you might need to only wrap it around once. And then make sure that the rubber band is up here. When you store it in its gun mode, the rubber band might go back down there. That's not going to lock it in place. You gotta twist it kind of until it comes back up right there. Now it's locked in place, so there you go. But yeah, that's just my way of locking this thing in place. There's lots of other ways to lock the little mech tech weapons in place. But yeah, I like this though. This is a pretty cool weapon. It's nice. It's a nice claw, but it's kind of better as a gun. Pretty nice little gun. Now, here's his SUV mode. It's a Chevy Suburban with big tires, as you can see, although they don't look big because this figure is actually small. Rolls pretty nice. He's got two red lights, though, not red and blue. But yeah, it's kind of like, looks like a Secret Service type of car, like the ones they use in the first movie that Sector 7 uses. And yeah, there's claws under here, big pinchers to bring them out. You can fold them out like that and then kind of fold them around. These are very, very soft plastic. Then fold the other one around, and now we got like a crab bot type car, a lion ant thing. It's pretty weird looking. I guess it's a pretty good attack mode, I guess. And like I said, they're very soft rubber. You see how far they can bend back. They're a little bit, I don't think they're warped. I think they're supposed to be bent that way. But yeah, it's not that big of a deal to me, really. You can have them be as far out as you want. You can even get them up under the grill like this, which is kind of weird. But yeah, the vehicle mode, it looks cool, but it's way too small. Let me just show you how small he is when I compare him next to a typical deluxe. So here he is next to Bumblebee, and Bumblebee is significantly bigger. He's longer, wider, and just everything just does not fit too well. But, oh well. Like I said, it's a good little Decepticon cannon fodder drone, pretty much. Now, to transform this guy, take the whole back part like this and push it up. Odds are that's going to fall back down while you're transforming, but try to keep it up for there for now. Now come here and in the front, bend this back. You can't go all the way back right now because the arms are in the way, but it will eventually. And then you're going to eventually bend down the whole front, but just keep that back there for right now. Next, separate this back piece and bend that down. That'll become the feet. Then take the arms and pull them out. They're really hard to get back in, but pull them out and then take this and it'll bend up. Kind of like Transformers Animated Rodimus Prime. Bend that one up too. Fold down the whole chest region and bend the head up and kind of get the dreads out of the dreadlocks out of the way, excuse me. Twist the arms down and then put these things up so that there's two little pegs there and there, which will peg into holes inside this chest plate. You just gotta kind of fit it together. It's kind of hard to do, but there we go. And then just put the head down, and these things are supposed to turn back, but they won't. It's probably because they've kind of melted into the head sculpt during the packaging, but yeah. And then take these things, and they've got a hinge they can move up and down like that, and then there's a ball joint that allows you to twist it around. I like to keep it there. Bend this hand up, bend the wheel back, bring out the hand. As you can see, mine doesn't have the big middle finger, but I'm okay with that. And then do the same thing over here with this arm. Come on. There. Bring back the wheel. There's the hand. And now down here, don't ever forget to do this. Take the crotch and bend it forward. Don't forget to push that back in, though, when you're transforming him back. Now back here, this is hard to do the first time, but this piece right here does bend back all the way at that angle. And then push this here, and you can do whatever you want with these things. I just pretty much, they're useless in robot mode, but, so I just pretty much put them here so it's more movie accurate. Because they're actually more like shoulder pieces, not pinchers on his back. And then put that back there, come down here, split the legs apart, turn them around like this, push in the wheel, bring this thing down, bring out the toes, push the wheel forward, and then just kind of push this down, and there's the foot right there. And then you do the same thing with the other one. It's kind of hard to do to figure out the first time, but just remember that that wheel goes in, and then it kind of pushes forward. I like how the wheel is in there like that. That makes it look more realistic. And so there, we're pretty much done with Crankcase. There he is in his robot mode. Let me move the camera up. So there's his robot mode. Pretty cool. Standard deluxe class sized height, you see. And there's the big canister shaped things that his weapon will go into right here. And it looks like he's holding it, but he isn't. It's actually being held by there. He's not holding it with his hands, but I like to kind of put the hand back like this so it looks more like he is holding it a little. But yeah, there you go. And yeah, these things are kind of ugly. It's show movie accurate and everything, but they just kind of get in the way. You're supposed to bend them back, but you can't. Because actually, Crankcase in the movie had his dreadlocks were back more. And yeah, don't forget to push those feet back all the way so he stands a little easier. He doesn't have a huge problem standing up, really. It's just these things can move a little easily, so yeah. And yeah, like I said, mine does not have the big middle finger, but a lot of people are complaining about that. But seriously, why whine about it? I mean, seriously, who would want a figure with a giant middle finger? Yeah. Anyways, he's pretty cool anyhow. It's just the middle finger isn't quite as long as you can see. These two over here look more realistic, and you can tell it was just cut off. And I think that's what they do. They just took two little scissors and just snipped it right off. It looks like it was just snipped right off. But I don't care. I don't care. Like I said, who wants a figure with a big middle finger anyhow? So yeah, he is pretty cool. He's got a nice gun. It looks pretty sweet. It's kind of big, but it's not too big. It's not like really cumbersome like the deluxe Bumblebees is. And yeah, like I said, these things can be positioned however they want, but I do that. They don't have any use in robot mode anyhow, and I can't figure out a way to take them off. So I just keep him like this, pretty much. Yeah, he does have a problem with his legs doing the banana split, or whatever you call it. But he stands pretty nicely otherwise, like this. He looks okay. It's not that great of a figure. He's a bit of a shell former. The only part of his body that actually has some part of the vehicle incorporated into it, realistically, is the back, you see, with the bottom of the feet. But you could actually take off these, and the whole back piece, and it would just be robot mode, and you could fashion the rest of the vehicle mode out of it, besides the tailgate. So yeah, kind of strange, but oh well. He has a nice chest design, though, and the head sculpt is very nice, too. You're probably not going to get so much detail on my camera, but the head sculpt's pretty nice, so yeah. Do I recommend it? Well, yeah, I mean, like, he's inexpensive, so you can buy him. You probably have money, too. If you don't have the money, though, I'd save it up for something better. He's pretty good for the weapon, though. The weapon works pretty good on other mech tech figures, like always. So, yeah, I guess in one sense, he's worth it. Some of you guys probably won't like him. I can't highly recommend him as much as the others, but I guess it was worth it for me. So that's all I have to say about this figure, you guys. Hope you liked my review, and this is Optimus Smythe signing off.